Now, the next source of financing is lease financing. Okay, what is lease financing? To understand this, take an example. Now, suppose the business is into entertainment industry. Okay, now cameras have kept on evolving. The technology keeps on changing day in, day out. Okay, so there are more powerful cameras. There are more variety of cameras which are getting introduced. So in that scenario, a business might not want to invest in the camera, but then without a camera, an investment or a recording, an entertainment industry or a recording studio cannot work. So rather they would think about lease financing. Okay, what is lease financing? Let's understand that. See, it is a contractual agreement whereby one party, who that is the owner of the asset, will grant the other party the right to use the asset in return for periodic payment. So the recording studio, what they can do is they can lease the camera for some time period, okay, and then whenever they want a different camera, they can go and lease that another camera. So they are now saving the money of investing into the asset, that is into the camera. So what happens is lease financing is one party has the asset. So here, let's say company A would be having this particular camera and company B requires it. The recording studio needs it. So company A would lease the camera to company B, but this would be in return for a periodic payment, which is known as lease rentals. Okay. Now there are two parties to the contract, the lessor and the lessee. Now who is the lessor? Lessor is the owner of the asset. Okay, who is willing to lend that asset to another party. Now the person who is making the periodic payment, that is the person who is using the asset, would be known as lessee. Now when the contract is entered into by these two parties, that is lessor and lessee, it is known as lease contract. Okay, generally I gave you one example, that is the camera example I gave you. Otherwise such kind of contracts are prevalent in acquisition of assets such as computers, electronic equipments, which become obsolete quicker because of the technological development. So always remember, lease financing is famous or is in use in the industry or in those assets which become obsolete because of continuous changes in the technology. Now remember, whenever you are deciding whether I should go for lease financing or not, you should understand that the cost of leasing an asset should not be the same as cost of owning it. Now if I'm owning the camera, I can go and buy this camera, let's say in 5 lakh rupees. Okay, so the cost of owning the camera is 5 lakh rupees. So when it comes to leasing, the rental or the rent which I'm going to pay should not exceed 5 lakhs. It should be rather less than 5 lakhs. Only then lease financing would be helpful to me. Now let's understand the merits. The first is it enables to acquire the assets with a lower investment. Like I gave you an example of the camera. Okay, so assuming the lease rentals here are 2 lakhs. That is, I have taken a lease for 1 year and the rentals are 2 lakhs, whereas the cost of acquiring it is only 5 lakhs. So here my investment would be quite low compared to the investment of going and buying it. Now remember one more thing, that when you're owing an asset, it has a depreciation value attached to it. Other thing is, if this particular equipment gets obsolete, then you cannot even resell it. When you go to the market to resell, not many people would be willing to buy an obsolete technology. So now when it comes to the lease contract, there are very few documentation which is required. So there is simple documentation and it is easier to finance these assets. The next is the lease rentals which are paid by the lessee are deductible or allowed to be deducted from computable taxable profits. See, the main concern about sources of finance always has been that the interest which I'm paying or the cost which I'm paying for a particular source of finance, is it tax deductible or not? So the rent which you're paying for lease finance is allowed to be deducted from as an expense from your books of account. Now, it provides finance without diluting the ownership or control of the business. Now, obviously, I'm just leasing a camera, so the person who is giving me the camera is not going to ask me a share in the business, neither is going to take a charge on any other assets because I'm paying him lease rentals. So the another merit of this particular lease financing, that is this particular source of financing, is that it provides finance without diluting the control of the business. Now next, it does not affect the debt raising capacity. Remember, if a business wants to take any kind of loan, the debt capacity is always considered and it is an important factor. Now debt capacity would be seen on the basis of how many assets you have, how many past loans you have taken, what is your income, okay, currently, and what estimated income is there in future. So the moment you take any other source of finance, let's say if you take a bank loan of 100 rupees and your capacity to take loan is 500, immediately the capacity comes down to 400, okay. Now this is not the case when it comes to lease financing. What happens in lease financing is that the debt capacity is not affected because you're paying only lease rentals, okay. Now risk of obsolescence is borne by the lessor. So the risk of obsolescence here is in the hands of the lessor. The lessee doesn't have to really bother if the new technology comes in and this asset becomes obsolete. Okay, now let's see the demerits. The first demerit is restrictions on the use of assets. See, you cannot alter or you cannot modify the asset which you have taken on lease. Let's say a car. If you take nowadays, this is very common, especially in US, that the cars are taken on lease. Okay, when you're taking the car on the lease, you cannot add any modification or you cannot alter the car to your specification because it is under a lease contract. Now remember, normal business operations may be affected if the lease is not renewed. Now let's take this example, the camera example I gave you. After 1 year, you want to renew the contract. Okay, you have received a fresh new assignment and you want the same camera to be used, but then the lessor says, I don't want to renew the contract. In that scenario, you will be left in a issue. There will be an issue and you will be in problem. So always remember that normal business operation might get affected if the lease contract is not renewed. Remember that there is a higher payout obligation in case the equipment is not found useful and the lessee opts for a premature termination of lease agreement. Now let's say, take this example, you required the camera because the focus of this camera was considered to be very good, but then it turns out it is not really useful for you. So the camera is not giving you it's not solving the problem for which you have taken this camera, okay. So now the equipment is useless for you, okay. And what would happen now? You want to opt out of the agreement, so you will go for termination. So in that scenario, you will have to pay a higher amount. So high payout obligation is again a demerit for lease financing. This brings us to the end of the video.